Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Dunn, and I wanted to give you an overview of the holistic methylation interactive pathway chart. I created it to really kind of get anchor in my brain the biochemical pathways that affect our physiology and to remember what each of these genetic variants does and how we work with them. When you purchase the interactive chart, it's a one-time fee, and then we continually do updates on the chart. And when I find new information or if I find a new gene that I want to add in there, you won't have to pay any extra. And we also included, there are about 35 extra pages here, and there are various pathways. There's 28, actually. So we have all these other pathway charts in here that can give you a ton of information, including the hormone interactive chart is in here as well. So you can look up what's happening in the hormone pathways. So there's a ton to learn and a massive amount of information. So anywhere you see a purple balloon, those are enzymes that are sort of coded, if you will, by your genes. Your genes tell your body how to make that enzyme. And these enzymes all either speed up or facilitate these pathways. And so we're looking at biochemical pathways where we create energy out of our food, where we create neurotransmitters, where we fight inflammation, or we upregulate our immune system, or we create neurotransmitters that help regulate brain chemistry, how we detox, how we methylate, how we break down histamine. These biochemical pathways happen at the cellular level millions of times a second. And when you have a genetic variant in any of these where you see purple balloons, they can slow down these pathways and cause potential health risks or health imbalances. And so with each of these balloons, you can click on them and they'll open up another window and it talks about what that enzyme does, how it works, how we can inhibit it, you know, maybe in the wrong way. Like for this one, curcumin or turmeric is going to impair an already slow enzyme and cause a buildup of serotonin. And you might think, well, serotonin is a good thing, but too much of it can be a problem too. And that can cause a lot of irritability, aggression, ADD, ADHD, anxiety, et cetera. So we want to get it balanced. And to get it balanced, we look at, you know, diet and lifestyle recommendations. There's some lab work recommendations on some of these balloons. If you're a kinesiologist, you can use the kinesiology challenges. And then these are the basic nutrients we use to balance that particular enzyme if you have a genetic variant there. So each of these purple balloons is going to have that kind of information, but also each of the words are defined as well. And so you can learn a lot about the biochemistry of the body and what's happening. It's a ton of information here. Where you see the squares around a set of words, it's going to give you access to another pathway chart. And so you can go back and forth to the main chart here, but you can look deeper into any of these pathways and just learn a ton. Where you see a darker circle or a darker border around an enzyme, those are the ones that we find to be the most problematic when it comes to looking at genetic variants. They're the ones that can cause the most issues. And where you see a purple balloon, but not a big border on it, they're not quite as important to look at. We find that we don't see a lot of clinical relevance with them. And then where you see the pink ones, those ones are more under investigation. So we're looking at, do genetic variants in these particular enzymes show up on a regular basis, and do they cause imbalances?